All we had to do was sell tapes. I had a rap partner, and we got the ingenious idea, hey, let's just walk the streets of Oakland, and everywhere people sell drugs, let's go up to them and sell tapes to them because they have cash in their pockets. And it worked. We pretty much like a paper route. We just went from drug turf to drug turf and just sold tapes. And the demand was immediate. So the first day we sold one tape, the next day we had to go back and make more tapes to come sell to the same group of people. The people two blocks over, they wanted to buy tapes because they heard these guys playing them. They're like, y'all got something new. And, you know, let me get this, oh, and whatever. And we had a little hustle. So to me, I always related hip-hop to making money. I got like $5 on me. I'm like, damn, I want to go get some weed, get some beer, and I need a new pair of fucking shoes. That'd be my thought. I'm like, I'm about to go sell some tapes. By the end of the day, smoking weed, drinking beer, with some new shoes on. Boom.
What's my favorite word?
My ducks, my swans, welcome to the pond.
My name is Dorian from group82music.com, and right here, we got Too Short talking about how he used Dope Boys to market his music. I really, really love this clip for two reasons. Stuff I've been talking to y'all about. Number one, Too Short used people that already had a brand, that already had an influence, that people looked up to, that people knew, in order to put his product in front of more folks. This stuff's been going on forever. So technically it was kind of influencer marketing back then, except his influencers were Dope Boys. When y'all look at the videos like these that I make sure that I pick a celebrity, or I make sure that I pick a brand, or I make sure that I put numbers in the caption to bring y'all in. Because y'all know Too Short, y'all know 50 Cent, y'all know Drake, y'all know Apple. Y'all know $1 million. Y'all know what that looks like. So that brings you into the clip. The clip is good. I put my analysis on it. Y'all fuck with it. Y'all follow me. And now y'all are part of what I do. Y'all part of the pod. This is the exact same thing that he was doing with his music. You need to take that strategy for you. That leads to the second reason why I like this clip. I don't know why I was about to give y'all the three. What my daughter be doing. Second reason I like to. I'll do it for my baby. That's the second reason I like this clip. You have to find accounts on Instagram. This doesn't really work on YouTube. You gotta find accounts on Instagram that are similar to what you do once you find your brand, your theme, that have a large following, and you need to follow them. You need to turn on post notifications. And whenever they post, you need to go to whatever video or post they have, you need to read it, you need to write a meaningful comment. If you're one of the first ones, you write a very meaningful comment, they might pin your comment to the top. If they pin your comment to the top, now everybody's gonna see that. And if you wrote something good under an account that's similar to yours, but has a much bigger following, guess what all those people are gonna do? They're gonna read your comment, they're gonna hit like, they're gonna argue with you, whatever, but they also gonna click your account. And now if you have good content, now if your link in the bio is good, now you just got new fans, you've got new audiences to wait for you to bring them in. It's the same thing that Too Short was doing right here. The exact same thing. If the Dope Boys like it, shit, I must like it too. That shit has worked forever. I gave y'all a story before with Adidas, Adi Dassler, and Jesse Owens in the Berlin Olympics. I gave y'all that before, right? These are the things that you gotta do. And influencer marketing ain't going to somebody's DMs and paying them $1,000, $5,000, whatever to post your product. I don't think that's a good investment anymore. I think it's much better to take their content and use it. Give kudos if you want. You got to. It's content. They don't really care. They know they're getting free pub from you anyway. And then add your shit to it. Or going to their section and bringing value to their comment section. If you consistently do that, that is a free way for you to bring attention to you while they are spending millions or billions on their brand. Don't ever say Duck ain't never helped you. Because I have helped you. I helped you niggas a lot. Some of y'all still ain't downloaded our free ebook, How to Get 1 Million Streams on Spotify. You in YouTube, it's in the description box. You on IG, it's in the link in the bio. Go click that, download the free ebook. If you have done that, what are you waiting on? Do you got 1 million streams? Then why ain't you bought no goddamn package yet? We ain't promising you 1 million streams, but I'm gonna give you every single thing that has got me there. I got 4 million streams. I had a number 7 album in the world on all genres on iTunes. If you trying to get like that, there's some shit you want, because I know I wanted that shit. So if somebody would have told me, offered me something to put me there, I'm going to listen to what he got to say. If that's you, click that link in the bio, purchase more packages for 60% off right now. I'm out the pod. Y'all stay true.
Fetty's coming at the donuts. Killing like a Michael Porter. Getting buckets a quarter. Filling pockets a owner. Fetty's coming at the 2music.com.